streams.
Louder.
Welcome back to another Trail of You Boys podcast. This is the radio voice of Damien. How you doing, guys? Hope you're doing well. Today, we're going to look at the trailer for Free Guy. So we'll run this through and listen to us do a critique straight after.
Mondays, am I right, Joe?
You said it, guy.
Yeah.
Don't have a good day. Have a great day.
Everybody down on the ground!
Hey, bud, you ever think that there's got to be more?
More than what?
The stuff we do day after day. Being shot at? Run over? Taken hostage?
Everybody down on the ground!
Today's going to be different. Hi.
God, this isn't you. You don't do this, man.
Maybe I do.
Joe, this is scary.
He's just resting.
In pieces. That man is dead.
He's so sleepy.
But it's just a squeeze me.
Is this what recreational drugs feel like?
Guy, this world, it's a video game. And it's full of bad guys.
I'm a rule breaker. I'm a rattle chicka 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 snaker.
We need you to be the good guy.
I'm sorry! Oh, God!
Is that a Glock in your pocket?
No.
What?
It's two Glocks.
Oh! I'm not gonna be the good guy. I'm gonna be the great guy.
Okay. Well, enjoy your lifetime supply of virginity. Off you go.
I'm so psyched for Ryan Reynolds right now. Can't wait.
I don't know, man, but straight off the bat, guys, before I say anything about anything else, it gets sound straight away.
Oh, Mariah Carey, or for just sound as in
like... it gets sound in music for the Wilhelm scream being in there.
Oh, there's all sorts of cool
that's straight up
sounds
the Wilhelm scream in there. Yeah. It's getting a tick. It's getting a star.
I'm with you on that one.
It's getting a star, but now. Yeah, man, Taika Waititi, it looks like he gets to just play himself.
Yeah, which is awesome. Right?
And that guy's sense of humour is just fucking hilarious. So, yeah, and it would be nice to see him in like something that's not too obscure either. Ryan Reynolds, yeah, man, it feels like he's on his second win, man. Like, you know what I mean? Built his way up, had a few knockdowns, man, did a few not-so-good films, got critically slagged. Like,
this is cool. Look, somebody has sat down and said, oh, you know, Fortnite did so well. Why do we make it into a movie?
Sort of. I think this is like someone's watched Ready Player Number One.
Yeah.
And then thought to themselves, what if we took this concept one step further?
Yeah.
So instead of it being the player in the game, what if it's an NPC?
I'm intrigued to see if
self-aware in the game.
Ryan Reynolds' character Guy is part of the game system, or is actually somebody playing from the other side.
So the plot thickens.
Yeah.
So, well, we'll give it a star for that because it really, other than that, you know, other than action pursues when he puts the glasses on, which allows him to see view the get the world as the game that it is, you don't get anything that gives the plot away.
No.
Which, you know, and other than him being a good guy and fighting bad guys again, it doesn't give it away. Casting wise, I just want to give a shout out where Jodie Comer is concerned, because she's like seems to be exploding at the moment in her stardom. She's done some really good BBC One
she has,
stuff.
Yeah. Killing Eve.
Killing Eve, which I've been saving, so please do not spoil for me, anyone.
Oh, okay.
Saving to watch that, because that seems like a really good BBC.
Similarly, from my point of view, yeah. Joe Kerry, head of Stranger Things, yeah. I really like him as an actor.
I like him. I like him as a person as well when he's done interviews. Like, he seems to be a really confident young man.
Yeah, he does, doesn't he?
And he just seems to know what he's talking about as well. Yeah. So, no, I agree with that, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I love the character names. So I'm going through and you got Ronald Guy. Just the generic names they use, like Lil Harry, just as Buddy. So it's just like they've just thought, what names do
same
people use online?
Jodie Comer, just a Molotov girl.
Yeah. And Keys. So it's like,
Keys. Yeah.
You know,
yeah, it is like
they've used
names.
Such generic terms that people use online, just Guy.
Oh, I feel sorry Buddy. For this Owen Burke, though.
Right.
Bank robber, hashtag two. Fuck, bro. Like,
and there's another guy, Aaron
W. Reed, who looks like somebody I made.
He looks like
on
a dude.
Royal Rumble, back on the PlayStation 2.
Yeah,
like, all steads, all roided out, man.
Sophie Levy, Big City Dreamer. There's just this looks like a super cool film to go and watch.
Man, no, it does.
All
it
ages.
Does, oh my god, is that the guy who I think it is?
All ages.
No, it can't be. Okay. Oh, gutty. I thought that.
You know, I want some of those glasses, man. Those sunglasses.
Oh, where it tells you about bank and all that.
He gives him all the information on the screens, playing music, and they're that's the future. Oh, that is that. You know what? We're there. We're almost there with that. Apple's due to bring that at some point.
Google Glass. Tried,
Google, man. Apple. One of the big tech giants. They're working on it, man.
They tried.
Working on it.
Dude,
still.
There's already a product out there. That's what I'm trying to fucking tell you.
They're just perfecting it, bro. Before you know it, there'll be machines walking around trying to take over. So
that I believe, like straight on with you on that one. But now we're
so where do we feel we are with some of the critiques?
It's hard to say because I was going to say about editing, but it feels it's got a nice flow to it.
Yeah,
but it feels very generic.
So
I don't want to slash that.
You're not saying it's edited massively well.
Nah,
no.
Well enough for a trailer.
Yeah,
is what I'm trying to say, but it doesn't. Yeah, you know, it feels generic. Feels like any blockbuster. I'm not trying to say this is trying to be like the next BAFTA winning and Oscar award nominated film.
Yeah,
but at the same time, the trailer does seem like it's been edited together as like
as well as it probably could have been.
Possibly, I'm willing to give it half. Unless you want to make an argument for full.
No, I wouldn't even say we have to give it half.
Oh, okay.
So I mean. It definitely makes us want to see more.
Yeah, we've got two so far, saying and wanting to see it, not giving the plot away.
Doesn't really give away the plot away. And special effects and sounds, for sure.
Standard,
so.
Four stars,
man.
That's pretty good, like, to be fair. It might turn, it's a four star trailer, okay? Sorry, we've been saying
trailer. Film. Yes,
like,
you're right.
To be fair, you might watch the film and it might be like a five star fucking film.
Yeah.
And to be fair, I think people give Ryan Reynolds a hard time, man, because he's a five-star actor. Like, he is.
I know he had a few blips. For one film.
There's a couple, but yeah.
Is that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Green Lantern. And he played...
I knew Green Lantern would be one of the obvious ones,
Deadpool, Dave, X-Men.
Yeah. Right, okay.
Wolverine.
You know what? Yeah. Good shit.
But again...
Let's throw your pen around for you, bro.
Dude, I'm fucking upset that they did that to him. Like, but again, not his fault. It's just
fair
he's
play.
A paid actor doing a job.
Yeah.
It just didn't go his way. Like, you know, I mean, look at Christian Bale. He can't have had any idea that when he did.
True.
Batman.
Batman
Begins, that he was going to turn into the Dark Knight in the Dark Knight Rises.
Yeah.
Like, there was no chance that they knew that that was going to be the mega massive.
That's the vision of Christopher Nolan for you.
Yeah, that motherfucker knew.
Yeah, he knew.
That's what I'm saying. The actors, not so much.
I'm happy for Ryan Reynolds to put these type of comedic films out all day long.
It just suits him as well.
I'm just curious to see how his latest Netflix film lands on the 20th of December, I think. I could be wrong on that, depending on where you are and where you listen to this from. Six Underground.
Is that straight to Netflix?
That is
straight to Netflix.
Straight to Netflix.
So you guys, the plot thickens, man. Cinema's changing. It's everything's... Yeah. Things are going so differently these days, man. I mean, me and Damien grew up in a world much like it, most people listening to this, I imagine. Yeah. The only place you could really go to see a new film was the cinema, unless you knew a guy that knew a guy and got you a dodgy burned off CD.
But we were talking about this also the other day, that you go even further back. If you missed a film on the cinema where they didn't have televisions,
shit, man, you're going video players,
you missed a film back, and you never saw that film.
I think, dude, I don't think there's anyone still alive that remembers those times. Like,
oh,
brother,
come on. But no, hear me out. Further you go back, I'm trying to say is, we were talking about this the other day, and it used to be that if you didn't make the film at the cinema, you never saw it.
True enough.
But now...
True enough. Or that some films that were released on cinema just never got put on DVD.
Because there are films out there that bombed at the cinema, but then once DVD released,
it went huge. Yeah, there's a few like that.
I mean, TV series, Breaking Bad was one. Yeah. And not that it went on the cinema, but it bombed in its initial release on television, but Netflix brought that back and made it huge.
Yeah, true enough. It's interesting how it changed, like, it's straight to Netflix. But, we're going to have to watch out for any more of these films. Seem to go straight to Netflix, especially with our Disney channels going on at the moment. I mean, but shying away from the subject, I think Free Guy, yeah, man. I want to go and watch that.
Yeah, for sure.
Definitely.
Yeah.
So I'm up for that. 4-star rating, guys.
Okay.
I've been Alex for Trailer View Boys.
I've been Damien. And don't forget to subscribe, like, and leave us any comments for any trailers you want us to critique. And we'll see you on the next one.